Right, hello again guys. Hope you enjoyed that little workout clip. Today's actually going to be a different video. We're actually going to the beach today. It's quite a fairly sunny day outside. But while I'm on the beach, me and a few of my mates are going to answer some fitness questions. And I'm also going to talk about this little one. Not the whiteboard, but actually what I write on it. And I'm also going to explain three basic tips that we're going to need for every single goal that we have in mind. It could be a business goal, it could be a fitness goal, it could just literally be a task to do during the day. But these three important tips are going to be what we need to do the goals. But with that being said, let's get to the beach, let's enjoy some sun, and I'll catch up with you when I'm there. So that beach trip didn't last long, did it? When we got there, it was real sunny, but typical Cornwall, changed weather in 2 seconds. It then became windy and rainy, so we left as quick as we can. So today's Friday, which is actually check-in day for me, or check-in for the videos anyway. I actually haven't got a coach, so it's just checking in with my YouTube. I've seen in previous weeks, I've been putting up videos of me posing and also taking my weight every single Friday. I actually take my weight every day, but Friday is the day where I actually write it on the whiteboard and then I can see the progressive of the weeks. As weight fluctuates from day to day, so I just take one of the week. And the main reason I put the check-ins on my YouTube videos is just so I can look back in 3 or 4 weeks' time and see where I began. Like I have been recently, I've been going back over all my videos and just checking to see how I've been looking each week. I haven't really noticed a difference yet. I think I've noticed the most difference in from last week to this week. So I'll quickly show you the poses right now. Still not a huge amount of weight lifted, but it's definitely coming off. So we're just going to keep going at it. Oh, there's no limit of amount of weeks. It could be as long as I want it to be. I'm aiming for about 20 weeks. 20 weeks of cutting down, but if I need to go 30 weeks, I will go 30 weeks. With that being said, let's get into the 3 points that I was on about earlier in the video. So 3 points I want to talk about are actually the fundamentals of success. These come before training, diet, and recovery within the fitness industry. So we really need to know these and understand these before we actually go and do our goal. So first principle is adherence. Now no matter how your training looks, how your diet looks, or how your recovery looks, adherence is the most important part. It's the be all or end all. Now basic definition of adherence is pretty much staying on a straight line, staying on that road, and not going off once. Now if we look at this with training, if we're following a training plan, we're following it dead on, we're not going off track once. Some people, you can give them a plan, they'll follow it to a T, and they'll never go off plan once. But other people, you can get them go off track every now and then, and all they need is a little boost to come back. And some people just can't follow a plan at all and they just keep going off track. But don't worry if you're not one of them, you don't have to be discouraged by it, as at some point everyone's going to go off track. There's always going to be a point where someone's going to go off track no matter what. So don't lose your positivity or your drive towards that goal when your adherence does go off track, because your adherence can really cost you your progress. For instance, like overeating, if you're on a diet, if you overeat, you're going to cost some of your progress by overeating and going off track. Same again if you're trying to bulk up, if you undereat, you're going off track, you're not sticking to your plan, you're also costing your progress. But the one point I want to say about adherence is just be honest with yourself. Be honest with yourself, be honest with your coach, be honest with anyone that's trying to help you with your adherence or with your goal. So you should pinpoint when you went off track, when your adherence cost you your progress. If you write down when your adherence cost you your progress, you can actually pinpoint the area that went wrong. You can write down what went wrong, how to fix it, and then next time you know how to fix it, you know how to not go off plan. And that way, with more experience and more time, and maybe with more mistakes that you're making, you can actually learn yourself a bit better. You can learn where you will get off track, and you can keep yourself on track because you've gone off track before, and now you can fix it and you can keep yourself on that straight road and towards your goals. That's why when you see professionals and you think, how do they stick to it? It's because they've made the mistakes in the past. They're years ahead of you. They've had that more experience and they are now just on a straight and narrow. They know they won't go off track because they are fixing it. And if they do go off track, they can fix it straight away. Don't worry if you've got a lapse in your adherence. If you have, just try and fix it. Don't just let it go past. You want to learn and... Don't just let it go past. You want to learn from your mistakes. And you want to keep going on that straight and narrow towards your goal. It might just take you longer than other people, but you're still going to be hitting your goal and you're not just going to go off the track. Now, point two, or principle two, is organisation. Now, if we're organised, it's going to make us much easier to stay on track. If we plan out our meals, if we cook ahead, if we pre-make our meals, we can stay on plan a lot better. But we also want to be tracking everything to make sure we are staying on track. Definitely with our fitness, we want to track our weight, we want to track our lifts to make sure we are staying on plan towards our goal. For instance, with me, I've got my whiteboard and I track everything. My morning weight, what I eat, my morning weights for the last 10 days. I've only got 7 on that at the moment, but it will be the last 10 days soon and I'll re-rub it out and then go again. I've also got my days planned up there and I'll just cross off the day that I've done. So, front, back, rest, arms, cardio twice a week, 10K steps, and write how many times I've done it. So, 5 times so far this week, and then I rub it off again, do it again. And then I've just got a little quote at the bottom saying, don't sit down, because I've done burn that weight. This way I can be much more organized. I actually know what I'm doing every day because I can just look at my board and see, right, I've got a front workout today, I've got to eat that many calories today, this is my weight yesterday, let's see if I weigh less today, and that way I can stay on track. So if you're organised and you plan stuff out and you pre-cook meals, you can stay on track a lot better. Now obviously people are going to go off plan and they're going to have days where they haven't organised it or don't plan ahead, because some days you get stuff where you don't plan ahead and stuff happens. Life always seems to get in the way of our planning skills. So that's where, like, if you fit your macros comes in, where you eat off plan, but it still hits your calories and your macros. So as long as you know your calories and your macros, you can eat whatever. You don't actually have to meet a meal plan. And there's always stuff around it, which I'm pretty sure I've explained in previous videos. So if you are struggling with organization skills or with diet skills or training skills, you can always just click back onto one of my videos and there should be some information there to help out. Now the third and final one was going to be passion, but I think the better word for it is drive. And the reason that is because sometimes we don't have a passion towards our goal, but we need to have a drive towards our goal to achieve it. So for instance, people with underlying health issues aren't motivated to go to the gym, but they need to go to the gym. So they're driven to go to the gym because of that underlying health problem being their driver. That's what's motivating them to go to the gym and lose that weight to then get rid of that underlying health problem like obesity. But obviously that can then dilate into having a passion. If you do then have a passion towards the gym, it's obviously going to help you a lot better because you're obviously going to be pushing yourself harder because you actually have a passion then. When you're passionate about stuff, you obviously try harder because you enjoy it more. And then obviously then you're going to be more likely to go and to do stuff because you're actually then passionate about it, you like it, you enjoy it, and you're going to be having fun doing it. But for every goal you've got, you need something to drive you to do it. If that's passion that's driving you to do it, if that's an underlying health problem that's driving you to do it, if that's just getting the deadline, if that's just getting the coursework in before the deadline, that's the deadline then driving you to do that assignment. So we definitely need something that's going to drive us to do our goal. If that's what we really want to be famous, we're going to drive to be famous, you've still got that drive there. And we need to be thinking about all three of these before we even start going to do our goal. So I hope you enjoyed the video, hope you learned a bit. And if you did, leave a comment, let me know, like the video as well, and I'll see you guys next time.